In this video, I'm going to show you 6 things you should do after installing Disqus. First up, update the community settings for your site. Starting in your community settings, let's take a look first at pre-moderation. Pre-moderation lets you configure the types of comments that require approval before they can appear on your site. You can pre-moderate all comments, comments containing links, or comments that contain certain words or phrases. The media attachment setting lets you decide if readers should be allowed to post images when commenting on your site. Comments can also be automatically collapsed from view in the discussion after it has been flagged a certain number of times. We recommend setting this to 3 or 5 flags, but that may vary depending on your audience. You can also automatically close discussions after a certain period of time. This helps you manage the volume of comments to moderate and allows your team to prioritize newer and more active threads. Next up, add moderators to your site. A well-moderated community encourages more readers to participate in discussions and keeps your most loyal users coming back. Moderators can approve pending comments that have been flagged for review, delete comments that violate your policies, and ban users. You can add someone as a moderator by entering the username of their Disqus account from the moderator's settings page. If you manage multiple sites, consider adding admins to your Disqus organization so you don't lose access if someone leaves your team. We recommend designating a shared team account for this purpose. Turning on moderation email notifications for new or pending comments lets you stay on top of the latest comments. Each moderator would need to enable this for their own Disqus account from their moderation settings. You can even moderate comments directly via email using simple keyword commands to approve, delete, or mark a comment as spam. Replying to the email notification also lets you respond directly to the user's comment. When posting comments, moderators have a badge that appears next to their name so that readers know who they are. This badge can be customized in your community settings. Finally, update your user profile by adding your avatar and a short description to make it easier for readers to get to know you. Let readers know where discussions are happening by displaying the comment count for articles on your homepage. Comment count links also make it easy for readers to return to a discussion in just one click. Implementing comment counts requires adding a JavaScript code snippet to your page. For more detailed instructions, check out our knowledge base article for help on getting started. Your comment policy is a place for you to set the tone of your community and remind folks about the rules for commenting on your site. In Disqus, you can create a comment policy that appears directly above the comments. This makes it easy to align expectations with readers when commenting from day one. You've added Disqus to your site, but you haven't announced the update to your readers. This is important so that readers have the opportunity to understand your goals for commenting on your site, to share their feedback, as well as to test out the different features. We've seen some publishers provide a simple tutorial to help readers get started with setting up an account or posting their first comment. Finally, it's time to participate in discussions happening on your site. First, engage with readers by replying to their comments. You can answer questions, welcome first-time commenters, or simply thank someone for their contributions. Upvoting valuable comments is also a simple way to show your appreciation and lets readers know that their feedback is welcome. So that is 6 things you should do after installing Disqus. If you haven't installed Disqus yet, check out our installation tutorial videos in our channel. Thanks for watching!